So welcome you all for the whole online classes. We have started the chapter kinetic theory of gases. So yesterday, so we completed, we have started level 2 questions. We will continue remaining questions of level 2. So last question number is 5. Now we'll see question number 6. So what is the 6th question is? Then is, the gas at a pressure P naught contained in a vessel. The masses of all molecules are halved and their speeds are doubled. So what is the resultant pressure? What is the expression for the pressure according to kinetic theory? Which is 1/3 into, if there are n number of molecules are there, so and each molecule, if there are n number of molecules are there, mass of each molecule is m. So m into n. Actually the formula I've written 1/3 into rho into Vr plus O. Rho is the density. Density can be also written as mass divided by volume. What is the formula for density? Mass divided by volume. So if there are n number of molecules are there, total mass is given by m into n by V into Vr minus O. Correct? Density is equal to mass by volume. So the each molecule mass is m. There are total number of molecules are n. The total mass is given by m into n by V. So by this relation, it is clear that pressure value depends upon these factors. How does pressure value? So pressure is directly proportional to which one? Mass, and also directly proportional to RMS velocity. Understood, Anna? Where m is the mass of each molecule, RMS velocity of each molecule, then P2 by P1. So is equal to M2 by M1 into, can I call it as V2 by V1? They telling that mass of each molecule is half. So what does it mean? M2 value is M1 by 2 and speed of each molecule is double. So what is V2? V2 is equal to 2V1. Understood? How pressure related with each and every molecule mass and its speed? It directly proportional to so speed of each molecule square, and it is directly proportional to mass of each molecule. So then from this, what can I write? P2 by initial pressure, they given it as P0 is equal to M2 value M1 by 2 by M1 into, so what is the value of V2 value? V2 value is 2 into V1 by V1 whole square. V1 V1 cancel, M1 M1 cancel, which is given by 1 by 2 into 4. So 2 1s are 2 2s are. So what will get the answer for P2? P2 value given by 2 into P1. What happened to the pressure? Pressure is double. Understood? So this is question number 6th. Okay, next one. Question number 7. At a given temperature, the root mean square velocity of oxygen and hydrogen. I think we discussed this question, we got it. First question, this one only, na? So what is the ratio at given temperature? What is the ratio of root mean square velocity of which one? Oxygen and hydrogen. So oxygen molecule and hydrogen molecule. So seventh question, root mean square speed of Vrms value inversely proportional to molecular weight. When at a constant temperature, when temperature is constant, so root mean square speed is inversely proportional to molecular weight. Now RMS speed of which one they are asking to validate? So oxygen molecule O2 and hydrogen molecule H2, which is given by root of molecular weight of which one? Hydrogen by molecular weight of which one? Oxygen. They are asking, so RMS, the given temperature, the root mean square velocity of oxygen and hydrogen. So that is, what is mass of hydrogen to oxygen given by 30? 2 1s are 216. So what I will get the ratio? The RMS speed of oxygen and hydrogen are in the ratio 1:4. Correct? So root 16 value is 4. This is question number 7. Next, question number 8. So what is this question is, in the two vessels same volume of atomic hydrogen and helium at a pressure, so 1 atmosphere and 2 atmosphere at A. So question number 8, in two vessels are there, this is one vessel and this is one vessel, first vessel, second vessel, this is our first one and this is our second one. In this hydrogen atom is there, in this helium is there, hydrogen 1, 1, helium 2, 4. Their pressures are given, so this pressure is 1 atm and this pressure is 2 atm. Okay, now they're telling their volumes are equal, this volume is V and this volume is V. So temperature of the both the surfaces also same, so T value same. Now they are asking average speed ratio. What is the formula for average speed? V average value root over 8 into R into T by pi into N, which can be also written as root over, what is another formula? So that is given by root over 8 into P into 8 into, one more formula in terms of pressure also we can write here directly in terms of molecular weight alone, because at a time it does not depend upon pressure. Already you know one point, at a constant temperature RMS speed value does not depend upon pressure. When I change the pressure, density also changes, that's why RMS speed value remains constant. Then whatever the answer given by here, average speed also inversely proportional to molecular weight. Now the RMS speed of which one I want to calculate? Average speed. So average speed of which one? Average speed of hydrogen by average speed of helium will be equal to molecular weight of helium by molecular weight of hydrogen. So average speed they represented like this symbol, which is equal to molecular weight of helium is 4 by 1. So then what will get out? CH value will be equal to, so this is 4 root over 2 into CH, that is average speed of hydrogen is how many times? So 2 times the average speed of which one? Helium. So this is question number 8. Okay, now next question number 9. In this question, so I think that there is a, we are getting a difference in answer, so you also can check it once. What is the velocity of monoatomic gas having a pressure 1 kilopascal and density 2.8 kilogram per meter? So which speed are they, have not mentioned. Let me calculate RMS speed. So question number 9, pressure is given it as how much of 1 kilopascal. 1 kilo means 1 into 10 to the power of 3 pascal. Density given it as 2.6 kilogram by meter. Now if they, for example, let me calculate VRMS, root mean square, that is which gas, monoatomic gas, RMS value given by the formula in terms of pressure and density, 3 into P by rho, so which is given by 3 into, so P value how much of 1 into 10 to the power of 3 by rho value how much now? So rho value will be equal to 2.6. Then what I get the answer, which is root over 10 into 3 by 26 into 10 power 4. To remove the decimal, I kept here 10, then 10 power 4. So 3 ones are 3, 8.66 will be. So 10 power 4 root is 100 by root over 8.66. Then what I get out, which is equal to 100 divided by 2.8.66 square root of 2.9, nearly 3. So 3 and 3 means relate answer nearly of 33.3 meters per second. They not given, they given as the option 25 meters per second, but as per given data, so this is only the answer. For suppose if they ask to calculate average speed will be equal to how many times? So average speed value will be equal to 0.812 times the RMS speed. Then also option is not there. If I calculate the so one more speed is most probable. That also answer is not matching. So I think once you also check it, the answer for this question. Okay, this is the question number 9. Next question number 10. So important question. So what is this question is? A cylinder of capacity 20 liters filled with the hydrogen gas. H2 gas. The total average kinetic energy of translatory motion of molecule is 1.5 × 10⁵ joules. So what is the pressure of the hydrogen in the cylinder? What is the formula for the total pressure? 1/3 × mass of each molecule into number of molecules by volume into Vrms whole square. Correct? This is pressure formula. Can I multiply numerator denominator with 2? Then what I'll get? Which is 1/3/2 or 2/3? 2/3 × 1/2 × this is total mass is capital L into Vrms whole square. Okay, Nara? What is capital L? M into N I called a capital L, which is 2/3 × V, which is 2/3 × this is total translational kinetic energy. So that is kinetic energy by V, which can be also written as P value 2/3 × can I call kinetic energy E by V? What is V there? Volume. So this is the required formula to do that problem. In this problem, data is volume is 20 liters. 1 liter 10⁻³ m³. And kinetic energy is 1.5 × 10⁵ joules. Okay now? Now can I substitute the what is P? P value 2/3 × E value 1.5 × 10⁵ by what is the value of V? 20 × 10⁻³. So then 2 ones are 2 tens. Then what I get the answer for P is equal to, so can I write numerator 15 × 10⁴ by a denominator value 3 × 10⁻². So 3 ones are 3 fives. Final answer for P 5 × 10⁶ Newton by meters. Okay now, this is question number 10. Next, question number 11. Understood now this relation, already you know this relation, but in terms of volume. So P value 2/3 × E/V. So question number 11. What is this question number 11? The value of universal gas constant is 8.3 joule by mole by Kelvin. The mean kinetic energy of 32 grams of oxygen at −273 degrees Celsius is how much? In this question number 11, what they asking us to calculate? The translational, the mean kinetic energy they asking to calculate. So mean kinetic energy formula. For which gas? The value of universal gas constant given oxygen. Oxygen they given na? So that is for which gas? Sir? The value of universal gas constant given. And mean kinetic energy of 32 grams of oxygen at −23 degrees. First let me write R value given ra. R value 8.3 joule mole inverse Kelvin inverse. Then mass given. So mass value is 32 grams. So we know molecular weight of oxygen. Oxygen molecular weight is 32 grams only. O2. So then temperature given it as −73 + 273, which is 200 Kelvin. Temperature conversion is compulsory. How can I calculate the number of moles? Number of moles is given by the formula. Mass divided by molecular weight, which is 32/32. So I got the answer 1. I want to calculate the mean kinetic energy. So that mean kinetic energy is given by the formula, which is F by 2 into N into R into T. So F value for oxygen, that is diatomic term. So for O2, the number of degrees of freedom is given by 5. Then 5 by 2 into N value is 1, R value 8.3 into T value 200. So 200. You multiply the value, then what I get? 8.3 into, so that is 8 3s are 15. So, and 5s are. So what we get, the answer is of, that is of 5 by 2 into N into R into T, na? 5 by 2 into N value is equal to 1 into 8.3 is given. So 8.3, in terms of 8.3, what we get answer? The mean kinetic energy of 32 grams of oxygen at minus 73 degrees. Answer again, it is small difference. Minus 73 plus 273. So that is of 200 Kelvin. So that is 5 into 1 into 8.3. Number of degrees of freedom correct only, na? So number of degrees of freedom is 1 by 5. Answer I think we should get 2490. So what we get 5 on the 5. 5 3s are 15, there. Then 5 8s are 40. So 41 getting. But 41 optional in order. Where the value of universal gas constant, that is 8.314, okay. So M value 32 grams also okay. Temperature also okay. They tell you only one oxygen molecule. It is not O2. Here they tell you only oxygen. Only for oxygen. If it is a monoatomic, the number of degrees of freedom given by 3. So that time what I will get, which is of 3 by 2. 3 by 2 into, here we get. So 8.3 into T is 3. 3 is 9. And 3 8 is 24. So 24, what I will get? 24.9. into 100, which is given by 2490. Okay, now so here also mass is given 32 grams, that is of 2490, correct? Here they given only O, not O2. If they mention it as O2, then directly. Even if number of moles also, what they telling you, the number of moles also not equal. Directly you can write F by 2 into R into T. This is all not necessary. So directly R value given, F value given, T value given. Mean kinetic energy formula F by 2 into R into T, which is given by universal constant here. Total value na R into T. So this is question number 11. Next, question number 12. So what is this question number 12 one is, if the number of molecules of H2 are double than O2, then the ratio of kinetic energy of hydrogen and that of oxygen at 300 Kelvin. So what is the kinetic energy formula, total kinetic energy or average kinetic energy formula, which is F by 2 into, so for one molecule if I write means K into T. For total gas if I write means F by 2 into N into R into T. Okay, now F by 2 into R into T. This is the formula for kinetic energy. The total kinetic energy. Okay, there they need to mention, that is kinetic energy per unit mass. So this kinetic energy only directly proportional to which one? Temperature. It is independent of number of molecules. So due to that reason, the number of kinetic energy of which one? Hydrogen and kinetic energy of which one? Oxygen are in the same ratio, 1:1. Kinetic energy does not depend upon number of molecules. The number of molecules of H2 or double than that of O2, what is the ratio of kinetic energy of hydrogen and that of oxygen at a constant temperature? At a constant temperature, kinetic energy does not depend upon number of molecules. That is question number 13. In this question number 13, at which of the following temperature the molecules of the gas having twice the average kinetic energy at they have 200 degrees Celsius? Question number 13. What is the initial temperature is 20 degrees roughly. So 20 degrees Celsius. 20 plus 273, which is 293 Kelvin. So initial kinetic energy, can I call KE1 is E and KE2 is 2E. Kinetic energy to be double. They are asking us to calculate what is the temperature, what is the relation, kinetic energy directly proportional to T. From this, so KE2 by KE1 is equal to T2 by T1. From this, T2 given by KE2 value of 2E by KE1 value of E into T1. E cancel. So T2, 2 into T1, 2 into 293. How much it is? 586 Kelvin. What is the value in terms of centigrade? 586 minus 273. So which is given by 313 Kelvin. Okay now, at what temperature kinetic energy will be double? 313 Kelvin. This is question number 13. So all questions what are there in level 2, so that we have completed. Now let us go for level 3. Okay, in this level 3 only 8 questions are there. That 8 questions will see. So question number 1. There are 4 particles are there. Their speeds are 3, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 4 particles. V1 is 2 and V2 is 3. V4 is, V3 is 4 and V4 is 5 centimeters per second. All values are in centimeter per second. Okay now, what they ask you to calculate? What is the root RMS speed? What is the RMS speed definition? So that is V1 square plus V2 square plus V3 square plus V4 square by 4. Total number of particles are how many? 4. This is equal to root over V1 square 4, V2 square plus 9, V3 square 16 plus 25 divided by 4. So then 9 plus 16, 25, 25 plus 25, 50, 50 plus 4, 54, root 54, divided by centimeter per second. Generally, till now we calculated if the given temperature or pressure, density, RMS speed. If the speed of the individual particles are given means how to calculate RMS speed by this. So, this is question number 1. Understood now? Next. Question number 2. So important question. At room temperature, RMS speed of molecule of certain diatomic gas found to be 1390. In this given question, they only given RMS speed. So V RMS value 1930 meters per second. Now they ask you, this is all our diatomic. So our gamma value diatomic of that is given by 7 by 5. They are asking, this is the RMS speed. This speed is corresponding to which molecule? What is the formula for RMS speed? VRMS is equal to root over 3 into R into T divided by capital. They are telling room temperature. So room temperature. what is room temperature of here? Generally we can take T value 27 degrees Celsius. 27 plus 270. Can you take 300 Kelvin? Compulsory temperature in Kelvin system. Now let how we compare which gas means by knowing the molecular weight. If you substitute the VRMS value, capital R value, T value, you will get M value. By knowing the molecular weight, you can justify. So that is which gas? Square on both sides. VRMS whole square value 3 into R into T divided by capital. From this, capital M value is equal to 3 into R into T divided by VRMS whole square. Substitute the values 3 into 8.314 into T value how much of 300 by VRMS value. So 1930 into 1930. Two zeros of two zeros of cancel. Then what I get? 9 into so 8.314 divided by 193 into 193. So numerator multiply 74.26 something like by 193 into 193 approximately so 37,249 something like that. You can multiply it. After dividing these both, you will get the answer 2 into 10 to the power of minus 3 kg, which is 2 grams. Now you tell me 2 grams corresponding to which gas? So F2O, O2O, Cl2O, H2O. You can remember the H2O RMS speed value 1930 meter per second. So important question. Okay, now this is question number 2. Next, question number 3. The absolute temperature of a gas increases by 3 times. Even this question also key answer wrong. Absolute temperature increases by 3 times. Now what they are asking us to calculate? Root mean square velocity. What is the relationship between root mean square velocity and the temperature? So we are in this formula root over 3 into R into T by capital. RMS speed value directly proportional to root T. They tell you temperature increases by 3 times. So what happened to V2 by V1 value root over so T2 value 3 times 3 times. Then what I get V2 is equal to root 3 into V1. RMS speed will be increased by root 3 times. But they given I think option is 1 by 3 times. But temperature increases means RMS speed never decreases. So root 3. This is question number 3. Next. Question number 4. All are same models. Maximum motions are based on this RMS speed only. The temperature of an ideal gas increases from 27 degrees Celsius to 927 degrees Celsius. That is fourth one is T1 is 27 degrees Celsius. 27 plus 273. How much I get? 300 Kelvin. Temperature increases to final temperature 927 plus 273, which is given by 1200 Kelvin. Now they tell you that RMS speed value. So RMS speed formula VRMS directly proportional to root 2T. So then what happened to V2 by E1? Root over T2 divided by T1, which is root over 1200 by 300. 00, 31s are 34s. So what happened to V2? 2 into V. RMS speed will be increased by how many times? Double. 2 times. This is question number 4. Next, question number 5. So what is this question number 5? All are simple questions. So that's why completing a number of questions more. Question number 5. In this 5, RMS speed of oxygen molecule at certain temperature is 0.5 km per second. The RMS velocity of hydrogen molecule at the same temperature. Again, same molecule. RMS speed of which one is one? RMS speed of hydrogen by RMS speed of oxygen. Molecule now is root over molecular rate of hydrogen, molecular rate of oxygen by molecular rate of hydrogen. Molecular rate of oxygen 32 by hydrogen is 2. 2 ones are 260. Then directly you can write the RMS speed of hydrogen will be 4 times the RMS speed of oxygen. So V value for H2 will be equal to 4 into, so what they given, 0.5. They given that RMS speed of oxygen molecule is 0.5 meter per second into 0.5. So what are here? 2 meters per second. Directly, whenever they given oxygen molecule and hydrogen molecule, so RMS speed of which molecule? Hydrogen molecule will be 4 times the RMS speed of which molecule? Oxygen molecule. Directly you can multiply. Till now you got this problem 3 times. So every time what you need to multiply? Multiply with 4 times. So that is question number 5. Question number 6. So what is this question is? The average translational energy and RMS speed of molecules in a sample of oxygen gas at 300 Kelvin. So they given translation kinetic energy E1 value 6.21 into 10 power minus 21 joules, and also given RMS speed V1 value 484 meters per second. This is at the temperature T1 is equal to, so how much of at a temperature of 300 Kelvin. Now they asking at a temperature of 600 Kelvin. So what is the kinetic energy value and also what is the RMS speed value? Okay, now. So we know that translation kinetic energy value directly proportional to T. Then whatever it is, T2 by E1 is equal to T2 by T1. T2 value 600, T1 value 300. So 1s are 2s. That is E2 will be equal to 2 into E1. So 2 into E1 value 6.21 into 10 power of minus 21. So what I get over is 12.42 into 10 power minus 21 joules. This is the value of final kinetic energy. Now I want to calculate final RMS speed. RMS speed value directly proportional to root T. Then V2 by E1 is equal to root over T2 by T1. Root T2 value 600 by 300. 1s are 2s. What does it mean? V2 is equal to root 2 into V1. Root 2 value 1.414 into V1 value 484. 484. Then multiply this 1.414 into 484, you get 684 meters per second. This is the value of V. And this model also important for CET point of view. Okay, now for doing this problem, you should know that average kinetic energy value directly proportional to absolute temperature, whereas RMS speed value directly proportional to root over absolute temperature. So that is the question number 6th. Next, question number 7th. Here this is also same one. The temperature of an ideal gas increases from 120 Kelvin to 480 Kelvin. So at 120 Kelvin, RMS speed of molecule is V. This is V now. Same model question. This is the value of V. Now they are asking at 480. In this question number 7, so RMS speed VRMS directly proportional to root T. Then V2 by V1 is equal to root over T2 by T1. Final temperature given it as 480. Initial temperature is 120. 120 ones are 124. So V2 is equal to 2 into V1. So V2, V1 value given it as V is equal to over 2 times. That is question number 7. So last question. So that is question number 8 only. So this is the last question of level 3. In this, at what temperature? So is the RMS speed of oxygen gases, hydrogen molecules equal to that of oxygen molecule at 47 degrees Celsius? Question number 8, important. They tell you at what temperature. So what RMS speed of this molecule, RMS speed of hydrogen molecule, hydrogen molecule will be equal to RMS speed of oxygen molecule. At what temperature this RMS speed values are equal? They ask you. What is RMS speed formula? Root over 3 into R into kinetic of the hydrogen temperature is T1 by molecular rate of this one hydrogen will be equal to root over 3 into R into, so temperature is T2 by molecular rate of O2. So square root is cancel both sides. 3R3R also cancel. So then what I will get? T1 by molecular rate of hydrogen will be equal to T2 by molecular rate of oxygen. I want to calculate the given T1 value, T2 given. So T2 given it as 47 degrees Celsius. 47 plus 270. 47 degrees Celsius. Answer is they asking in terms of which one? In terms of Kelvin only they asking. So what I get? 273 plus 47. So 10, 1, 11. So 11, 12. And here is a 1. That is of 320. So then what I get? T2 value is 320 Kelvin. When it is 320 Kelvin, now you check it. So T1 value I want to calculate. T1 is equal to molecular rate of hydrogen by molecular rate of oxygen into T2. So then what will get T1? Molecular rate of hydrogen is 2 by molecular rate of oxygen is 32 into 320. So then what will get answer? T1 value. So 2 ones are here, 10 are correct. 2 divided by 32 into 320 Kelvin. So 320 in 10 I got it. Okay. So then already answer is there in Kelvin. I am thinking that again I have to answer to the change for so Kelvin. But already I converted into Kelvin. So T1 value is equal to 20 Kelvin. What is T1? The temperature of hydrogen. So that is hydrogen at 20 Kelvin temperature will be that RMS speed value same as that of oxygen at 47 degrees Celsius. Okay. So this is question number 8. And this is regarding kinetic theory of gases. Okay, very small chapter, but one or two models still are there for advanced, for mains level. So that few models that you will get in level 3 only. Okay, that almost concepts we have discussed. And these are the questions of this kinetic theory of gases. So by this completion of this chapter, the heat, what are the chapters are there, that all chapters are complete. In the next class, we will continue. So, one more new chapter. Okay, na? Thank you.